First of all, guys, once again, thank you very much for your time. Dominic, this question's first for you. Last season, fans have seen very little accountability and poor inconsistent communication with the supporters. As a CEO with a background in communications, will engagement with supporters such as this event today continue to be such a high priority after season tickets have been sold?
Hi, Erin. Thank you for your question. Hopefully today demonstrates my openness and keenness to engage, and that's going to be a cornerstone of my administration. As a Celtic supporter, I spent my whole life supporting this club and feeling connected, and I want to make sure that the connection that I enjoy growing up supporting this club continues whilst I've got the huge opportunity to lead it. So absolutely, connectivity between ourselves and the support is utterly vital. And I maybe said earlier on that one of the most important things I think that we need to try and grapple with is getting supporters back into the stadium. I've really missed it, you've really missed it, being in and amongst friends and colleagues watching the game. So I think we're making some good steps forwards. The Euros have been really positive in terms of having crowds back in there, and you can see the energy that the players get from that. So that is the ultimate piece of connectivity, getting supporters back in. But in terms of making sure that we're able to keep you updated and listen to you, we'll definitely want to do that.
Absolutely, thank you. And on that note as well, on behalf of the Kano Foundation, once again, a massive thanks for the season tickets. That is a huge step towards amazing progress, so thank you. Ange, it's an absolute honour, and welcome to Scotland, first of all. It must be quite a transition in terms of the weather, but I'm sure you'll fit in quite well. My question for you is, during the week, you had said that you want to entertain the fans and you want to win. But to win, that doesn't just take you, that takes a whole background team. Do you plan on appointing your background team? And if so, when?
Yeah, again, there's definitely going to be a change in the way we work and the way we train and the environment. And the people who will be in that environment would be the ones who I think can drive us in the direction I want to go. So... will there be changes? There probably will be changes. That doesn't necessarily mean people will be going. We might be bringing other people in. But I'll make those decisions over the next few weeks once I get a good idea of the people that are already in place. There's some good people in the football club already. You know, the club had a lot of success for a very long time. You don't want to discard that knowledge and experience because of what happened last year. But we're certainly heading off in a new direction. And... I'll find people that will help us go in that direction. So I'll make those decisions over the next few weeks. But you can be assured the people that will be working with me will be pulling in the same way that I am in terms of the kind of football we want to play and the kind of football club we want to be.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, both of you. It's an exciting time, and thank you again for your time.